My name is Shannon Norris, and this is my story. In 2006, I found myself as a single woman, not knowing exactly what I was supposed to be doing. I was a teacher. I had gone to Bible study. I had a great group of friends. I had traveled, and I had done all this stuff. I was born in Alton, Illinois in 1970, and March 19th, 1970, and 2 weeks later, I was adopted by my parents. I was in foster care in those 2 weeks. Growing up, I always knew that once I became an adult, after I married and had children, biological children, I was going to adopt. But at the age of 36, that still hadn't happened for me. So I started asking God what it was I was supposed to do with my life. In questioning God, what was I supposed to be doing, without saying anything to anybody else, people started to say to me, "Why don't you adopt a baby?" A couple months later, a totally different person, "Why don't you adopt a baby?" I started meeting people that had adopted children internationally. I kept seeing Caucasian families with Asian children, and more frequently, within a period of 3 or 4 months, these little God winks kept happening along the way. And even in the middle of a plaza in Italy, there were 3 Caucasian families with Asian children. And I thought, this is just ridiculous. So I came home and I thought, all right, God, all right, I get it. This is what I'm supposed to be doing. Found an international adoption agency in St. Louis that matched really well with the services that I needed. And I applied and I was accepted. It seemed very easy, and then all of a sudden the stuff started happening where things slowed down. I just kept praying, God, help me with this. Am I still supposed to be here? 4 years later, I was still waiting. And so I called my agency and I said, what do I have to renew? I am ready. And they said, well, it's still probably going to be another 2 years. Well, in the meantime, I had been teaching a class with a variety of different kids with special needs. And through that brokenness, God had opened my heart to look at a child that had a special need. I called my agency and I said, listen, at what time do I get to start looking at a thing called a waiting child list? And those were kids that had issues that might be a little harder to adopt than a kid with non-special needs. And she said, well, we can go ahead and do that now, but we need one more approval and then it will be fine. So the date was arranged that I took off from work one day and I stayed home. And the lady from my agency actually took over my computer, got me logged into some kind of a system. And she said, let's just click on this first file here. And we clicked on this file and we both went, The lady from my agency said, she's fat. And I said, she's healthy. And it was the sweetest, chubbiest little baby that I had ever seen. And I went with 2 files of little girls and met with a doctor who did not know me at all. But I went in and said, I'm going to adopt one of these little children. Help me. And she looked at the one file and she said, spina bifida, no big deal. If it is, sue me. She looked at the other file and she said, wow, that's a lot. And as a single mom, I don't know if I would be ready for this. And I hope that I've made myself clear. This other little girl needs a mommy. I just don't think it's you. I was trying to explain to my parents the whole conversation, and my mom finally just looked at me and said, would you please give us the file so we can see this child? And I handed them the file, and my dad started to cry, and my mom just looked and looked and looked at her. And I think the decision had already been made at that point. And so when I told Tina at my agency that she was going to be mine, I had to stay quiet for 2 weeks. Now, if anybody knows me, staying quiet for 2 weeks about anything is impossible. So I had to wait until from May, Friday the 13th, when I first saw her face, until November 6th of 2011 to get her. And I got her, and from the moment I got her, she was the most amazing little girl that I ever met. And through that whole process, all I knew all the time was God was telling me, trust me, trust me, trust me. This creature that was His creation was placed into my arms and I got to be her mom. And that was so amazing. And then we got home. And then she didn't sleep for 6 months. It was an adjustment process for both of us, because I think the one thing that people don't understand about adoption is you're not being handed a grateful child who said, oh, this person has come to rescue me. You're being handed a scared 22-month-old who doesn't know you, or has any idea of who you are. All they know is everything that they've ever known in their life has been lost to them. And it's such a heartbreaking process, but in the same time, in that brokenness and fear and scaredness on both of our parts, we became a family. And that has been so amazing. And one of the things that I think has been so amazing through this process is that God asked me to trust Him. And now He's asking me to need Him. Because being a single parent is the hardest job ever. And it's so rewarding. Every day I go to bed asking for forgiveness because I have failed her in some way. And every day He says, come to my throne. Come to me and I will give you rest. And here we are, 5 years later, a happy family. And who are you?
Audrey.
And whose class are you in?
Mrs. Denise.
And what grade are you in?
First grade.
And what do you love?
Pandas.
And?
Chicken. Disney.
Disney?
Disney.
Yes. Can you say hi to Yaya and Nana?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, turn around, look at the camera and say hi to Yaya and Nana.
Hi, Yaya and Nana.
Oh.